In this video, we'll show you how to create absence types in Personio so that your employees can request different types of absences, such as sickness, vacation, and parental leave. You can create as many absence types as you need for your company's requirements. Doing this will ensure that absence data is always current and allow employees to request absences, get them approved, and see their status in Personio. It will also help them manage their planned absences and, depending on their company calendar access rights, see other employees' planned absences. Step 1. Basic Settings. To create a new absence type, go to Settings, Work Hours and Absences, Absences. Give it a name and click the plus button. Select what color this absence will be when it shows in the calendar. Choose the absence category for your absence, for example, vacation paid. Then set whether it's measured in days or in hours. Absences tracked in days let employees take full or half days off, but those tracked in hours are more versatile. They can take a few hours off for a doctor's appointment or take time off from, say, one time on one day till the same time on the next day. They can also take a full day absence, but in hours based on their work schedule. So if absent on a 4-hour day, it counts as 4 hours off. Make sure you choose the right unit when setting up the absence, as you can't change it later. For absences tracked in days, you can require employees to provide a certificate when requesting them, and if so, from which day onwards. Step 2. Enable substitute requests. Substitute required means that employees name another employee as their substitute when requesting an absence. The substitution won't trigger handover of the employee's access rights or approval responsibilities to their substitute. It simply notifies potential substitutes that someone is going on vacation or another absence. Their substitutes will be displayed in the company calendar, depending on how viewing rights are set up in the employee roles. Substitutes can be not required, optional, or mandatory. If set to mandatory, you won't be able to import data for this absence type. For absences tracked in days, the Allow Employees Substituting for Someone to Request This Absence option defines if employees named as substitutes during a certain period can still request this absence type. You should only enable this for unplanned absence types such as sick leave, and disable it for planned ones such as paid vacation. This ensures that an employee substituting for someone can't go on vacation during this time. Step 3. Validity Settings. The Valid On option sets which days of the week should be counted when calculating the absence entitlement. Absence entitlement is calculated based on the overlap between the assigned work schedule and the days selected within this option. For example, if you have employees who work weekends and automatically have bank holidays off, you would choose the option Valid On Work Schedule excluding public holidays. Tick the Consider Time Track During Absences of This Type as Overtime option if you're creating a non-working absence, one where employees don't work, such as paid vacation. Any hours worked during a non-working absence will be counted as overtime. This will mean that any employees on an hourly wage will be paid their hourly rate for any hours in their work schedule for that day. If you're creating a working absence, such as home office, then don't tick this option. This requires that the employee track their working hours in Personio themselves. Step 4. Assess if accrual policy is needed. Accrual policies allow you to set a total of absence days or hours that are available to your employees. Therefore, they are only needed for absences that can be taken a limited number of times, such as paid vacation. For absences that can be taken an unlimited number of times, such as sickness, you don't need to create them. So for absence types like paid vacation, you need to create an accrual policy by ticking the Enable Accrual Policies option. For absence type like sick leave or home office, however, you don't need an accrual policy, as you simply record how many days or hours the person was off and don't subtract it from a total amount. So for these absence types, you don't need to tick the Enable Accrual Policies option. If you decide that an accrual policy is needed, you can then proceed to set it up. Congratulations, you have now configured an absence type in Personio.